All right, because we got good shelling here.
Yeah.
And I know you're not a very shellfish person, but you take really good shelfies.
Ah, thanks.
When you're out doing those things. So Rachel's at Shell Museum, checking out what they have to offer. Hey, Rach. Hi again, Rachel.
Did you know that octopus are actually mollusks? And that's because, actually, Sam can tell us why that is. They used to have a shell.
They did, millions and millions of years ago. And unlike most mollusks, which have a hard external shell, they no longer do. They evolved away from that. But there's other qualities, too, they share with the rest of their mollusk kin.
And so these are, they don't have a backbone.
Correct. They're invertebrates. They don't have a backbone. This is a giant Pacific octopus, which is the largest species of octopus in the world. Does have 3 hearts and 8 brains, but
what?
So far as we know, no spine.
No backbone, but everything else. Yeah. That's incredible. Yeah. Very cool. Yeah. So he's the executive director here at the Bailey Matthews National Shell Museum, and you've taught us a lot this morning. But let's go over to this one next. These are the milk conchs. And I've seen seashells that, I mean, might not have been a milk conch seashell, but I've definitely never seen a conch's eyeballs before.
They're pretty amazing, and actually their eyes are really well developed. They have almost as much, apparatus in their eyes as we do, so as clearly as we're seeing them, they're seeing us almost
really?
As clearly right now. Yeah.
Oh my gosh,
yeah.
Very cool.
Yeah, and in here we have milk conchs, which are the male version of this species, and queen conchs, which are well known for the fact that they're under threat, especially in Florida.
Really?
But that's also queen conchs are where your conch chowder comes from and conch fritters and things like that.
Oh,
and they've been overfished and over-harvested, you know, for that purpose.
Wow.
So they're protected now.
Very interesting. I love this part of the museum, and this is kind of a new addition. When did all of this happen?
Yes, these aquariums opened a little over 2 years ago in spring of 2020. And the idea was that for over 25 years, the museum has had these great exhibits of shells.
Mm-hmm.
And most people who were coming into the museum didn't realize that shells came from mollusks, from living animals. So
Right. Here
was an opportunity to create a living gallery of different kinds of species of mollusks from which shells come, or in the case of octopus, from which shells don't come.
But, yeah. I love it. Yeah. So in addition to coming out, I mean, and doing kind of a self-guided tour here, you have marine biologists that speak at several times throughout the day.
Twice a day in the aquariums, we have what's called keeper chats.
Cool.
So that's when our aquarists, and aquarists are people who are trained in taking care of these animals and these systems, will talk to any visitors who are here about how we take care of the animals, the behavior of the animals, and just kind of an opportunity to go deeper on all of it.
Yeah, I love it. You really can learn a lot here. Upstairs, there's different exhibits that show how a mollusk does eat, in addition to some really cool displays.
That's right, yeah.
Exhibitions, that's the word I was looking for.
Yeah, we hope there's a strong connection between the living animals in the aquariums and the Great Hall of Shells with its exhibits of shells from all over the world.
I love that. If you're looking for something to do this weekend, this Sunday is a really great day to come out and check out the National Shells.
If you're from Lee County, Sundays are always a good day. It is always half price admission for Lee County residents on Sunday afternoons.
Very cool. There's a ton to look at and learn about here. Add the Bailey Matthews National Shell Museum to your list if you're looking for something to do at any time this summer.
All right, Rach, looks really great. Thanks, Rachel.
You're welcome, Greg.
Hey, if you want to visit the Shell Museum, and it really is a cool place, we've taken family up there before, and we've always had a great time. They're up on Sanibel, open 10 to 5. We got information, too, on abc-7.com.
If you have an idea that we can showcase on More Explorers, let me know. Send me an email. It's right there on your screen. I'd love to showcase something cool going on and meet you and get out there, dark and early, hang out. It's a blast.
Hi.